Tracy, come on, will you? It's 7:30.
Why didn't you call me?
Because of her.
Well, you don't just barge in.
Shh. You'll wake her up.
Don't make me laugh. I don't know how I'm expected to sleep with all this bloody hissing. You're like two pressure cookers.
I think that's dead sneaky, that. She's been moaning in the night and disturbing me.
Oh, God. One night that was. On my back. It was murder.
Yeah, well, you want to be quiet about it. Tracy's got to get through school. How's she supposed to study if she's half asleep?
Yeah, and I'm getting bags under my eyes.
Try washing properly.
What?
It's last night's mascara.
Who are you, ma'am? It's the ray of sunshine.
It's you. You're in the doghouse.
Why? I haven't had a civil word since I stepped in that door last night. And after all I've been through in that court.
Well, it was because Harry Cross was here. And she found out you'd opened your big mouth. I'm dead proud of my Uncle Frank. So is our Rod. We'd like to talk about him. But she'd get upset if it got back to her.
You're saying that to shame me, eh?
Well, I'm sure you could keep quiet about it. Because we can, and you're older than us. And we're more spontaneous, aren't we?
Oh, I had no idea that Ralph would go and talk. It's no wonder she's livid.
Will you make it up with her or what?
I'll speak to her when you're at school.
Do you want to go to the bathroom first?
No, you're all right.
It might be a long time.
Oh, I can't rush in the mornings.
Hello. Come on in.
Morning. Anything exciting?
Letter from Ireland. How are you this morning?
Well, I'm glad I know.
You seem calm.
Ah, well, I've been awake half the night churning it about. I felt I ought to start here. I could have sworn I'd be too early for you.
No, I've been up for hours myself. I even heard Harry and Ralph setting off. It could only have been about 6:30.
Oh, yeah. Off to Wales.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What you might call a turbulent night. All sorts of questions going around in my head.
For instance?
Well, I'd like to meet the girl. At least, I'd like to see a picture of her. Never seen one in his flat or in his wallet. Does he hide them away?
I don't know.
And the money, does he provide?
I'm sure he does. I don't know very much. I know he saw her on his birthday. I know he rushed off to see her when she was ill. I'm certain he's done all he can. You haven't mentioned Tom. You haven't mentioned how you feel about his not telling you.
That's something between him and me, I think.
I suppose he's got to know how you found out.
I think he does.
He's gonna hate me, Jim. He really is.
What's the alternative? Substitute some other lie for the one he just got rid of?
Yeah. Well, I better go. Hate being late at airports. So easy to miss someone.
Miss him on purpose. You don't have to break the news.
Would you blame me? I gave him my word. I gave him a solemn promise.
I've got the tickets.
Hey, do you know what? They're converting back to coal. They've developed a coal burner, you see, that gives off less sparks. Before, they were just setting fire to the forest, so they had to use oil on some of the trains.
£1.40 return. That's not bad for a return trip, is it?
And they can get refreshments on board as well. Coke and ice lollies and things.
Oh, well, that's appropriate. It's all children's stuff, isn't it? It's dinky land.
It's a narrow gauge, Harry. Anyway, I thought you came here to enjoy yourself.
I can make a critical remark and still enjoy myself.
What are you doing? What's that on your head?
Guard the extremities for warmth. It'll hardly be worth your while going to work, the time it takes you to get out.
If you're cold now in the house, you must be going down with something.
I'm just trying to work out what I could wear. But I'd like to go to a bonfire tonight. I thought the kids might take me. I slipped them a few bob across the fireworks.
What about your feet? Have you got any lined boots with you?
Oh, I'll lend something off our Tracy. Leg warmers or some of those long socks she wears.
God knows what you look like. Ask her first, right? I'm off. Hey, Mum, no loose talk while I'm away. Yeah?
You're only young once. You make the most of it, girl.
Tickets, please. Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I'm afraid you're sitting in the wrong seats. These are third-class tickets, but you're sitting in first-class accommodation.
These are special tickets. Look, ex-driver, British Rail. My friend's the same. Proof?
Yes, but your tickets are third class.
Well, obviously, the girl's made a mistake. A lifetime of service with British Rail, we'd automatically get first class.
Well, did you ask for first class tickets, Ali?
Oh, I don't know.
Look, you've only paid £1.40, and first class on your pass comes to £2. So you either pay me 60 pence each in excess fares, or else you'll have to move. Third class seats.
How long did it take you to become a guard?
Now, look. I've got a job to do. I don't want any unpleasantness.
Good. Then buzz off, then.
Right. I'll be back at the next stop. And I either want the excess fare or else you'll have to move.
Thank you. Tell me something, Dad. All this work you're doing for her, is she paying you, or is this your form of wedding present?
We haven't talked about that yet.
You two haven't fallen out, have you?
Why?
Well, she seemed a bit down at the airport. A bit strained.
Well, I'll tell you about that, shall I? I don't know if Heather told you, but I rolled up here once in search of you. I turned on your answer phone. You left a message about how you'd had to go down to Colwyn Bay. You remember what it was all about. Who you'd gone down there to see.
You heard the message, why are you asking me?
I'm asking you because I want to hear you say.
I went down there to see someone called Rowena.
Rowena? Yeah. Well, I asked Heather about her then, but she could tell me very little. A similar thing's happened again. Rowena's name is on a list. This time, I leaned on Heather to be a bit more forthcoming.
Are you saying you know?
This time, Heather told the truth.
I see. Well, no wonder she was... What a thing to come home to. My God.
She didn't just come out with it, you know.
Oh, that's all right. I don't think you have to protect her. She only gave me a solemn promise, that's all.
Look, don't you deflect it onto her. How I found out is irrelevant.
I'll tell you everything, shall I?
Please do. It had better make sense, I tell you. How the hell it ever could make sense?
It did do. It did. It did when I first started it.
But to carry it through all those years.
Once it was started, I was trapped. I just... I mean, the thought of all that time that you'd missed out. I couldn't see how I could possibly admit it, Dad, without crucifying you.
All right. I'll give you another reason. Admitting it would show you up. I mean, I've heard all about these fine things about you. You know, the risks you take at work. So bold, so forward-looking. These leaps forward. Well, don't you try and have a go at her. Not Heather. She's got the moral fibre, son. Your woman had the courage. You!
Now look, I don't want to have to raise my voice, but we are at the next station. I'd like you please to find a third-class seat, or pay the excess, or leave the train.
We've already left the train. Well, we stepped off to see the view.
Leave the train altogether.
Do what?
A railway has to be run by rules.
Who do you think you are? You don't think this is real, do you? This noddy outfit. You're just playing trains. It's pretend it's all a game.
Now, that is an insult to this railway. That's an insult to the railway staff.
Go on, you'll have me crying in a minute, son.
Well, you're not getting back on this train. Remarks like that. I'm not having you.
I wouldn't want to get back on the train. Are you a fit person to be in charge? Never. Where's your cool?
He carried the bags.
Get them off the train, Ralph. Right, you can wave it off now, sunshine.
Right. I will then.
You know what that BF stands for on his hat, don't you?
Blaenau Festiniog.
No, bloody fool. There you see. Good job we got off that train.
Well, I'll admit it gives you a chance to see the view.
Eddie used to love it here. You see, bales all around.
Of course, Grace was limited like that, even before she had to have the wheelchair.
Are you religious, Ralph?
Well, not the sort of thing you'd like to talk about.
Well, are you?
Not really, no.
Neither am I. But it makes you feel religious in a spot like this.
Well, the scenery's superb, but I'm not sure where the religion comes into it.
Well, they've been here so many years. The hills, I mean. So it they acquire a significance.
I see.
That is set against the human span. You know, sure, that is.
Well,
I lift up mine eyes unto the hills. You remember that quotation, surely?
Oh, is it one of those religious texts they've got up on all the stations? That's what's turned your mind to all this stuff.
No, Ralph, no, it isn't. Look at that power station there. One nuclear explosion, and centuries have gone in one foul swoop.
Well, I don't know. It's a deep subject. Is that what you talked about with Edna?
We had an argument, as I recall, about this fella. Whether he was married to this woman, or it was her fancy man.
Very different.
Yeah, well, women aren't keen on things of the mind, are they? They're just not interested.
No, minds of their own. Well, Grace had. And Edna, too.
Good old Edna. You see, I said I'd come back. Promised you I would.
All right, then. I was 19. Suddenly she was pregnant and my whole future was in doubt. I panicked. I knew me mother would go spare and go on about me marrying the girl. I couldn't just tell you, could I, and expect you to keep it from her?
It's not far from what you expected of Heather.
I never intended Heather to know. It was a pure chance.
Yet it was always on the cards. I mean, there was every chance something like this would happen. How could you sleep easy in your bed?
I've learned to sleep with a lot of things on my conscience. And I wouldn't be where I am today, would I, if I folded the least thing? I know this wasn't little, but... anyway... me at that age, I was dead ambitious and arrogant. Yeah, of course, you were right. I mean, fancy confessing and balls it up. Me, know-it-all Curzon.
But a mess like this just doesn't go away.
I know, but it can be contained, can't it? And that's exactly what I did. I managed Rowena and her mother without it affecting anything else. I didn't sort of mentally put you and her together. Well, why torture yourself for nothing? I thought, what's done is done. It's over. Let it rest. It worked.
Was I so off-putting? I mean, was I so distant from you that you couldn't just come and hint?
You had such high standards.
No.
Oh, you did! To me, then, you were such a bloody giant. No.
I can't imagine.
It's true.
Hey, remember what I said now? I had to lean on her to get her to tell me. If I find out you've taken it out on her, I just will not forgive you for it.
Do you forgive Rowena, Dad? Are you keeping it away from me?
I might. I have.
Sorry, really sick and headachey at work. I cried off for the afternoon. Thought I'd go up and have a lie down.
That's your house?
It's a horrendous headache.
Psychosomatic, probably.
Ralph Hardwick, Harry Cross. Hey, he used to work out of Lanky, didn't he?
Oh, we did. We're retired now.
Me too. Oh, I just do this for sentimental reasons.
What a great little railway, when you think of the gradients.
Oh, yeah. Hey, this takes you back, doesn't it?
The wheels squealing along the track. The sheer smell of it.
Now, look, I mean, if that's what turns you on, why didn't you ride back with me on the footplate? There's plenty of room.
So, your headache's better then?
Yes, a bit. You're right, I am prone to them if I get tense.
Well, not to worry. And, you may be physically frail, but morally, you're the tops. My dad thinks you're wonderful. A paragon compared to me.
Please don't.
Isn't that why you did it? How could I live with myself, Tom, if I have to keep on lying?
But that's true, I do have to live with myself.
And with me, remember? God, we're meant to be getting married. The one thing I'm going to want from you is loyalty. Because you know the world I live in. The way I've got to have eyes in the back of my head because of all those no-marks who can't bear your success, can't wait to see you fail.
Oh, isn't that a little bit paranoid?
Yes, maybe it is. But God help us if I think you're not with me. If I haven't got the trust of my own wife.
It would have been the same even if I hadn't told him. Do you not think that I'd have thought if you can do it to him? You're quite capable of doing it to me.
You never said that when you first found out about Rowena.
We weren't about to get married then, were we? I wasn't face to face with your dad and him desperate to know the truth. I like him, Tom. He's been really open with me. He really cares about my feelings, that man.
Yes. Yeah, that sounds like my dad, all right. How open, how unselfish.
Jealous of him, aren't you?
Yes, of course I am. He's really got something on me now, hasn't he? He'll really milk this one. God, if you think I'm into power, you don't know
You're
him.
You're so wrong.
I'm not. Tom, take Heather up a drink. Tom, play bowls with so-and-so. Make sure you're there on time for me, Tom. Every Tuesday, on the dot.
God, I never knew you felt like this. I never knew it was so complicated.
I need to go for a walk.
Will you be back later?
Probably.
Come as you come, Tom. Blaenau Festiniog. Yeah. Bloody fantastic.
Don't worry, love. It's natural at your age. All girls are bound to get a crush on someone.
50 years ago, and it was me.
Ronald Armstrong, the longest long jumper in the school. I'd not much else going for him, like.
Oh, I don't know why I'd just say girls. You want to see our rod mooning over there next door?
You do like someone, though. I know. I saw your letter. like that, Tracy. I wasn't nosing. I was just looking through your drawer for some leg warmers, that's all.
Well, where is it now?
Back where it was. I only glanced at it.
I'm going to kill you, Nan. I will. I kill you.
I should have taken a proper coat.
I wasn't sure if you were coming back.
No.
It's a relief.
It's a relief, he knows.
Listen, Tom. I've been thinking. If you want me to meet Rowena before the wedding, perhaps I can talk to her about Jim. It might be easier.
No. No, it's all right. I'll ask her mum to do it. There's another one who'll despise me now. Rowena.
Another one? Besides Jimmy, you mean?
It's amazing, isn't it? With parents. Or you can just go on wanting their approval.
God, he does love you.
And I let him down. That's why he's made me feel so damn small.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Oh, Tracy, love. Use your loaf. Your mum's just called me a blabbermouth. I've just sworn blind I'll mend me ways. So how can I go to her with tittle-tattle?
You could.
I wouldn't, though. Besides, what is there to tell? You've got a thing about a lad at school. You're writing lovey-dovey letters to him. So what? But if you want it kept a secret, write. I'll prove it to you. I'll prove it to myself. I'll not let one word out about it.
You mean that, do you?
Yeah.
Oh, no! Are you?